you did not have to do it. But I'm thankful that you did. I'm so grateful that you love me. I'm so grateful that you care. Because you did not have to do it.
August 28, 1963. A quarter million Americans, black and white, young and old, descend on the nation's capital in a show of solidarity. It was called the March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom, but it would be remembered as a turning point in the fight for civil rights. Among the speakers, the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who electrified the crowd with his stirring, "I Have a Dream" speech.
So even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream.
A few months earlier, racial tensions in the Deep South had erupted. News reports carried brutal images of fire hoses blasting at the backs of school children.
Wow, I can't believe we're still fighting over basic human rights. I remember my grandmother couldn't go to the same school, drink out the same water fountain, or eat at the same restaurant as other people.
I know, right? I don't know why it's so hard for people just to get along with each other. I don't understand. In school, we come together in large assemblies, do projects together, and teachers just encourage us just to do that, get along. I don't know why they were trying to pick a fight with them. All they were doing was having a peaceful walk.
Great. It was just a prayer walk at that.
That was all they were doing.
I'm glad they're not afraid to stand up for what's right, though. How y'all doing today?
Good.
What y'all been up to? Can I ask y'all a question?
Sure.
Have y'all ever been treated bad or seen somebody treated like unfair and then, you know, wanted to do something about it? What you seen?
I stuck up for somebody getting bullied. What you see, Davion?
I got hurt by somebody and then my friend came to help me. Jackie, what do you know?
My friends were talking bad about this person that I really didn't know about that. But I told them stop talking bad about the person. Aaron, what did you see?
My friend at recess was feeling really bad, so I tried to help him.
Those are some amazing stories, guys. I'm so happy each of you guys had the courage in your situation to stand strong and stand up for people who are in need, you know? God gives us the strength and courage to stand up for what's right in the face of adversity, in the face of things that are wrong, you know? So I'm so happy you guys were able to do that. And throughout history, you know, a lot of people have done the same thing. Nat Turner, you know, Medgar Evers, you know, Huey P. Newton, you know, Fred Hampton, Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Angela Davis, Angela Rye today, Tamika Mallory today, Sean King today, Attorney Crump today. So it continues today, and we have to keep that spirit, keep that hope, and be world changers. We have to be the change that we want to see in the world. And I believe each of you guys can do that.
I'm going to become a doctor and save lives.
I'm going to become a lawyer and a CPS worker.
I'm going to be a football player that has a football team.
I'm going to be a cook and ultimate shelf YouTuber.
I'm going to be a cook that cooks delicious food. Desserts.
And I'm going to be a lawyer and I'm going to be a judge to work to fight the justice system that's currently doing wrong things to everybody. They're not treating people fair. We are all world changers. We are all going to do something in our own field to continue to change the world. We will be the change that we want to see in this world with the help and strength of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Teach all of the kids of future generations to is still better and I'd repeat all the days of us. It's so cold all around me, I don't get it anymore. And I know we need your guidance, please, oh Lord. Cause when I'm down, I'm gonna need a helping hand. If we all just believe it, then we can. Where do we start it if it seems to not begin? We've grown so used to it that we can't picture the end. And how can you say that equality's for all when my people are suffering at the hands of broken laws? Man, I'm so tired seeing faces bruised by someone who should keep us together, not separate all the civil from the. So we'll keep on fighting, keep on pushing till finally things change. It'll have you wonder why we couldn't fix things earlier this. It's so cold all around me, I don't get it anymore. And I know we need your guidance, please, oh Lord. Cause when I'm down, I'm gonna need a helping hand. If we all just believe, we are tired of being broken, our hearts in pieces. Please believe it, we need a change now. Evil defeated, peace come upon us. Now or never, people come and be as one. All around me, I don't get it anymore. And I know we need your guidance, please, oh Lord. Cause when I'm down, I'm gonna need a helping hand. If we all just believe it, then we can.
Hey y'all, how y'all doing out there, man?
We're doing great. We're doing great. I hope everyone had an awesome week. Denise, you have an awesome week.
Man, it was great. It's hot. It is hot outside. Oh my goodness.
Yes, scorching.
Lord.
Oh my God.
Man, and then this coronavirus is going around. We got to be masked up. Some people are suited up. They got the hazmat suits on. Oh my goodness.
I know.
It's just crazy.
But I'm serious.
Thankful that God has been with us throughout the entire
time.
The whole time.
Amen. I tell you what. Watching the news has really got me going, you know, because we've had various leaders recently that have passed on, like giants, you know what I'm saying?
John Lewis, that's a giant.
Yes.
That's a giant.
Giant, you know? Not only he, but it was another one.
C.T. Sivian.
Yes.
C.T. Sivian, another great leader that a lot of people, you know, they don't know. He was a great activist. He was a minister at that, you know. Did a lot of great things for people during the civil rights movement. So, yeah, we've lost a lot of great people. But it's awesome to know that God has been through it with us all. And he's always going to be with us.
Absolutely. You know, it's like he's raising up more leaders,
he
know, to take their place. Because now that those leaders have passed on and they've gone home, you know, the new leaders that are coming along, we could follow in their footsteps, take their examples, and just push this movement on even further. And
that's,
you know, it reminds me of a great leader in the Bible named Daniel.
My man Daniel, that's my guy.
Man, I love that story. We're going to tell you about the story of Daniel. Most people know Daniel in the lion's den.
Oh my gosh.
Wow, the lion's den. Can you imagine?
Daniel.
In the lion's den?
Man,
what?
I don't know.
Can you imagine somebody throwing you into the den at the Dallas Zoo?
Right.
What?
Oh my gosh. The lion or a bear or just something out of this world.
I don't want any part of that. But let me tell you how Daniel handled his situation.
What happened?
This
what
is
happened?
What happened.
Tell me,
okay.
What happened?
First of all, Daniel had given, excuse me, God had given him a great ability to lead.
I believe that.
And the king that he was working for, King Darius, he recognized that. He said, you know what? That's my man right there.
Right on.
He is on his job. He's taking care of business.
That's
he's consistent. He's
yes.
faithful. And that's the kind of thing God looks for in his does. In his people,
mm-hmm.
you know? So the king recognized this. And so he put him over his whole kingdom. You know
oh,
what I'm saying?
My Lord.
He had like over like 120 governors,
big
I
boss.
Believe.
He's
yes,
a big boss.
He was a big boss, balling. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, he, like I said, he was such a great leader. He put him above them. So
okay.
they had to report to him. You know, some people, they don't like that.
They
you know, to have a little hateration
like
going on.
A whole
you know,
lot.
They don't like that.
Lot.
So
okay.
anyway.
Yes, ma'am.
As the story goes.
Yeah.
The two of those leaders, they took it upon themselves to go behind Daniel's back.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah. Mm. And they went to the king and
Sneaky.
Said, King, yo, check it out. Listen.
What?
I know that you're this awesome king, and we love you, King, and we think you're great. And because of the greatness that you know, exude,
oh, they
we
try to
think,
boost
yeah,
him
you know, they were flattering
they, you
him.
Know.
You know, they were buttering him up.
Yeah.
You know, they were really pouring it on.
Sprinkling some sugar
yeah.
and some glitter
yeah.
on.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, because of all this, we feel like you should start this special rule. And the rule should be for 30 days, nobody can pray to anybody except you.
What?
Nor the gods or anything like this. And the tripped out part about this, they knew that Daniel was a Jew. And that Jews during that time, you know, they were exiled and they were in this land, you know what I'm saying? So they brought their traditions and their customs
yeah.
and the things that they were doing to that land with them.
Audacity.
So one of the things they did, they prayed to God
yes.
three times a day.
Mm-hmm.
And Daniel, they knew, he prayed with his window open, prayed three
yes.
times a day, and they saw him doing this right.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how they couldn't get him, check this out, they couldn't get him on other fronts,
yeah.
you know. So they figured, okay, we can get him on the religious front.
Okay.
Yeah,
mm.
yeah, because he didn't have mm-hmm. his reputation was spotless. You know, his work was A1. So that's how they figured they could get him. So again,
yeah.
they go to the king, they give the king the background and everything
yeah.
and say, hey, yeah, you know, this is what we're going to do. This is what we think you should do, rather. You should devise this decree
yeah.
that nobody can pray.
And they got to pray to the king.
Right.
That's some foolishness.
That's
right
it.
There.
Yeah, they can only pray to the king. Now, hey.
Wait before.
Try Jesus. Not me.
There you go. So,
yeah.
let me tell you what King Darius actually
what
had to wind up doing. You know what? He went to Daniel. Again, the king said, look, I got to keep it 100 with you, Daniel. I got to keep my word in this. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to put you into the lion's den. Daniel said, bet. Okay, put me in the lion's den. Because you know what? They're going to see whose God is truly the
Come
living
on.
God. You know
Come
what I'm
on.
Saying? So, okay. King Darius, he put Daniel in that lion's den.
What happened?
And King Darius was scared. You know what I'm saying?
I believe
he was kind of nervous about
too.
That.
I'd have been scared. Because
first
myself.
Of all, okay, he had a rep.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Dang, I done put him in this lion's den. I know that this man's God is really the true and living
yes,
God.
Yes,
but now I got to sit here on hands and knees, you know, pins and needles.
Right.
What's
right.
really going to happen? So
uh-huh.
he didn't eat. He didn't call for no entertainment,
Stop
nothing.
It.
But he waited
yeah.
all night long.
Mm.
Early the next morning, he ran down there to that den. He
He's
had the guards go with him, rolled that stone away.
Uh-huh.
Yo, Daniel, what's up, man? You down there?
What's
Daniel
up,
said,
man?
Hey,
I'm
it's
here.
I, King. Long live the king forever.
Long live.
I am not harmed. God is true and every man is a liar.
Yes.
He sent his angels to shut
Protect
the mouths
yes.
of the lions. So, hey,
mm-hmm.
God is on time.
Every
he's
time.
He's always there, any and every situation.
Come on.
Hey, he's there. He's good.
Every single time.
He's golden. You know what I'm saying?
Am I?
We can completely lean, depend,
yes.
trust, and count on.
Every time.
And some of the main things that we want to take away from that is, look, God is mighty.
He is.
Who you know can protect you from a ferocious lion?
I'm
talking
one.
About a lion that's like a lion. You know what I'm saying?
God, that's
okay.
it. That's
he
it.
He can protect you from any type of hurt, harm, or danger.
And
it's
I believe
nothing.
That.
It's nothing out
yes.
there. Not nothing. Secondly, God helps us to stand up and be strong and
yes.
be courageous
mm-hmm.
against evil. I mean, all forms of evil. We don't have to worry about it. We don't have to fret. All we have to do is ask God, God, I need your help in this.
I need you, like right now.
I'm really scared about it. And I know other people are doing these things.
Mm-hmm.
And hey, it's not the popular thing to do.
It ain't.
But God, I need your help in this. And I need you to give me the courage I need to stand strong.
Yes.
And last but not least.
Mm-hmm.
When you are, this is the most one of the most important things.
Yes, it is. Yes,
when you are a child of God,
you got to know who you belong
and
to.
You obey Him and His will. Hey, ain't nothing can happen to you.
Not even a hair.
No harm can come upon you. In fact, the Word even teaches us this.
Yeah.
Touch not my prophet and do no harm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I know.
Wait, hold on. Wait a minute.
Oh, come on, tell him.
Wait a minute. And no weapon formed against you will prosper. No weapon, not even a lie, not even scheming, conniving.
Wait. Cheating. It may form, but it won't prosper.
Hey, that's what I'm saying.
Come on.
It may form, but it ain't going to happen.
It won't happen.
You know what I'm saying? What they say? He'll shut it down. That's it.
One more time.
Really?
He'll shut it down. There it is. Every time.
That's it.
Every time.
So we thank you so much for joining us today,
man. This was a blast.
We love you and we appreciate you.
Yes.
And we want you to remember most of all that God loves you.
Always.
And He loves you unconditionally.
Unconditional.
And He stands at the ready to help with whatever you're going through, any and every situation. He wants you to stand courageous like Daniel did in this.
Yeah.
And He wants you to reach out and ask for His help so you can stand up even when it's not popular.
Yes.
Okay? And remember again, it's available. All you have to do is reach out and ask.
Yes.
Okay?
That's all you have to do.
So we thank you for joining us. But there's
one more special treat. Pump it up. They got to get ready.
Wait, hold on. One special treat that we have for you. So get ready. We have a very special guest.
Yeah.
All right. We love you, we appreciate you, and we thank you for joining us.
Peace.
And now, time for today's mystery guest.
Ah! Hello, youth and children! It's me, Grace! I hope you guys are having an amazing day! We have a wonderful special guest! Can anybody guess who it is? It's Senator Royce West! How are you doing?
Hey, Grace, how are you doing?
I'm doing so great. How have you been doing with all this coronavirus and everything?
Well, you are in my backyard. This has been my office pretty much since the coronavirus. And I have been running campaigns from this location. I've been practicing law from this location. And I've been doing all the honeydews from this location.
Senator, can you tell me, what is a campaign? Because we want all of our friends to understand what a campaign is.
Grace, thank you for asking me the question. First of all, I want to let you know, you are the first puppet that I've ever done an interview with. You know, a campaign is just like we have three branches of government, the executive, legislative, and the judicial branch of government. Of course, we know that we have a presidential election coming up and also a congressional election coming up. And so when people get ready to run for office, like the President of the United States, they put together an organization called a campaign.
Okay.
And it's the responsibility of the campaign to get the person elected.
Okay. So, Senator, can you tell me, what do you do? Because I think everybody needs to know what you do, because you are important in our community.
Well, I'm a state senator. And a state senator in the Texas, we have a House of Representatives and a State Senate. There are 31 state senators in the state of Texas, and I'm one of those 31. And so I represent close to about 1 million people right here in the Dallas area.
That's a lot of people.
Believe me, it is, because sometimes they all seem like they want to call all at one time, but that's okay. I'm not complaining about that. And so what I do is go down to Austin, and I look at different laws. I introduce different laws, and I look at different laws that have been introduced to see whether or not it's in the best interest of the senatorial district, the people that I represent, to pass those laws.
Wow, you have a really important job.
Well, you know, I enjoy it. When you begin to look at, I'll give you an example. When I look back over my career, Grace, what I see is the University of North Texas at Dallas. I was able to pass a law to create that. I was able to pass a law to create the University of North Texas at Dallas College of Law. I helped Purview A&M University. So I've been able to do a lot of different things, and so I can see the footprints that I'm leaving behind.
I want to do something great like you one day. You know, but I think I got to go to college first, right?
You've got to go to college. I would recommend strongly that you don't have to go to college, but I recommend strongly that you do go to college. And the reason is to get the education. And don't just think the education is in the classroom. That education is also establishing connections with people that you will have relationships with for the rest of your life.
Wow, that's so cool. I'm so glad to be here with you today because I'm learning so much today.
I'm learning a lot also, Grace.
Now, I got one last question.
Sure.
Because sometimes things happen and we see things and sometimes we want to stand up for what's right, but sometimes we may be a little afraid. So tell me about the importance of standing up for what's right.
You know, I'll put it like this. If you don't stand up for things, Grace, you'll fall for anything. Listen to me again. If you don't stand up, you'll fall for anything. You don't want to fall for anything. You've got to stand up for what's right. You've got to make certain that you use the Bible as your blueprint. Make certain that you look at the lessons in there, that you get wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And once you get that wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, it'll hold you in good stead for the rest of your life, and it will help you make the correct decisions time and time and time again. Okay?
Okay. So, yes, I'm excited to heal the world. Hey, do you know that song? I'm going to sing it for you.
Well, sing it for me.
Michael Jackson, and he says a little something like, heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If we care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. Did you like that?
I like that, Grace. I really did.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, too, Grace. See you next time, okay?
Bye, everybody!
Bye-bye.
Hey, everybody. I am, again, so glad that you all were able to join us today for the exciting lesson we had today about world changers. You know, each and every one of us have opportunities to be world changers in our God-assigned community. And what I want you all to remember today is this. In the world that we're living in right now and throughout history, some people, excuse me, will treat you unfairly sometimes, simply because of maybe the way you look, simply because of maybe where you're from, simply because of just that's their just perception maybe. But I want you to understand something. You don't have to succumb to anything that they try to do, but you can lean and depend on God. God is there for you. He's there to give you the strength you need, the courage you need to stand up to each and every evil, or whatever the case may be that you encounter. Because there's people out there that will try to come against you when you're doing the right things. But I want you to understand something from all the leaders we heard about today. We heard about one, a biblical leader named Daniel. And in that story, Daniel had some challenges that he faced in the community that he lived in. But you know what? Daniel didn't let his naysayers, his haters, or whatever get him down. He went to God and he prayed to God and he asked God for the help that he needed so that he could stand up and he could be courageous. And God wants us to do the same thing. And you know what? Not only Daniel in biblical times, but there are lots of leaders that have since come that have also given that same example. Like for instance, even John Lewis. John Lewis was a leader that just recently passed. And you know what? He was that type of leader that stood up for people's civil rights. And he didn't care that he faced even death in some of those situations. But you know what? He had the courage. That's what our takeaway is. He had the courage to stand in the midst of it all. And he was successful. And what I encourage you to do today is go to God and ask Him how you can be those same type of world changers in your communities, It's plenty of things that you can do. And it doesn't matter if you're young, it doesn't matter if you're older. God has a special assignment for each and every one of us to do in our communities to change the world. So I want you to be safe, have an awesome, awesome week. And again, this week, think about what can you do to be a world changer in your community. All right, I'm out. I love you. You have an awesome week. Take care.